Hello?
Come and do a bit of maintenance.
I hope you're on double bubble.
Yeah, the governor's looking after it.
Good. What are you going to do?
Take one of the alarms offline. Check it over.
Yeah? Which one?
C341.
C341. There you go. Log it in there, then.
Oh, no, there's no need.
Who says?
It's all square.
Not with me, it isn't. You disconnect an alarm system, it goes in a book.
Nah, you see, somebody's dropped a bollock. This should have been done months ago. You see what I mean?
Hey, hey, hang about a bit. I'm responsible for what goes down here when I'm on duty.
I don't like to say this. But from what I've heard, you're not supposed to be here at all, are you?
Yeah, well, never mind that. I mean, the computer will show when an alarm system's offline, won't it?
Nah, you see, mate, that's all taken care of. You see, your lap linked the connection, so your computer's still getting the message. Everybody's happy.
No, no, out here.
Oh.
Well, then. Mick McGuire turned up last night while I was on.
Yes, yes. Nothing for you to worry about, Harry. Just a bit of a cock-up in the paperwork. Well, it's all knocked, square now.
He knocked off one of the alarms, a commercial system, a solicitor's office. And what I need to know is this on the level?
Christ, Harry, what a question. We've got retired chief constables on the board. This isn't a cowboy outfit.
Look, I took this job for the cash in hand, but that doesn't mean I can get treated like a piece of shit. I hope there's no misunderstanding about that, Steve.
Harry, I'm sorry you feel pissed off, but I can assure you this is an internal matter. There'll be no comebacks. Enough said.
I hear what you're saying, Steve.
Now, you better get off to work, mate. You'll be late for your tea chop.
So that's Sergeant Carol Webb and PC James Willits.
Yeah. You and Harry talk to the complainant, see what the strength of it is. We'll talk to Webb and Willits if it's a possible runner.
Sorry, Gov, I did it.
Come on, mate, get it together, huh? Graves is on the prowl this morning with a bad case of the hump. You don't want to get up his nose.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, what we got is a complaint that officers nicked two porcelain figurines when they were in charge at the scene of a sudden death.
Nearest and dearest.
That's the picture. Audrey Murdoch, niece of the deceased.
Mo, I'll bring you up to speed, Harry. I don't want to go through it again. I've got Corris to catch up on.
Okay, see you later, girl.
Cheers.
Bye-bye.
Well, I thought, I better blow this up to you. I mean, you're our security consultant. You're a director. And last night's paper was down to you.
That's not the point in question. Who is this guard who's giving you aggravation?
Well, he's down on the books as Harry Jarvis. But between you and me, I don't know this officially, of course.
Spit it out, Mr. Ripley. We're all on the same side.
I believe he is a serving officer.
Real name?
Naylor. Harry Naylor.
What goes around, comes around, eh?
Oh, you know him.
There's not a lot I don't know.
Well, How should we handle this?
Naylor's got tragic personal troubles, Mr. Ripley. If he wasn't desperate for dosh, he wouldn't moonlight in an armpit job like security. Try a backhander on him. Monkey ought to do it.
Will he wear it?
Handled in a decent manner. Don't insult the man's dignity.
I thought you wanted to talk sensibly, Tony, not rake over the past.
Angela, you're the one who's getting tense. I'm putting the situation to you. You're denying it. It's making you uncomfortable.
There is no situation. It's over. It's lovely to see you, Tony. Please don't spoil it now. Could we have the bill, please?
Certainly. Angela, will you stop kidding yourself? I love you. I know you love me. Christ knows you've screamed it often enough. Don't tell me that happens with Donald.
You shit.
I'm a shit you're in love with.
I keep trying to explain to you. It's not just us. I'm responsible.
Yeah, darling, I understand that. The kids, everything. I'm up for the whole bit. Just be honest with yourself, Angela, and front Donald up with it. Or I'll have to.
Oh, what's your girl?
Oh, Phil, wish me luck.
Hey?
CIB.
Oh, yeah, bollocks, aren't it?
Yeah, well, bollocks can be dangerous. I found that out years ago.
You'll be all right in there, Carol. You got it up front. It'll be all square, huh? Don't you fret.
Meals on Wheels got no response from the old lady. They asked the neighbours, nobody'd seen her since the previous day. Shout one out, our section sergeant out in a panda showing a probation to the ground.
That will be PC Willits, would it, Sergeant?
Yes, sir.
Why did you send Willits out to call it in? You're the experienced officer, you'd be sure to get it right.
I've got a 19-year-old probationer looking at his first corpse. She's got her eyes open, mouth open, voided her bowels in the bed. I can see Willits is about to be Uncle Dick on the carpet, which won't help anybody, so I send him out in the fresh air and give him a job to do, which preserves his dignity for him.
What can you tell us about the property in the room?
Well, not a lot, quite frankly. I mean, I do keep my eyes open, but I'm looking for vital signs. Evidence of violence, indications of suspicious circumstances. I'm not sizing up what's worth pinching.
I was hoping I'd catch you. I'll let you have your wages before I knock off. Come in the office. There you go. It's all written down as hours worked. Goes through the books easier that way, but it's more by way of a bonus. What call it? Compensation for imbuggerance in the course of duty. All fair play to you, Harry. We joked about last night. Should never have happened. Square things up between us. Like I say, it's fireproof in the book. Thank you.
Webb was the only person alone in the bedroom with the dead woman. According to her own statement, Willits was only ever there in her company. Later, there was the divisional surgeon, coroner's officers, CID, the whole circus passing around.
So there was opportunity. But that's all that is against her, and as far as I can see, it's worth bugger all on its own. We've only the complainant's word for it that the property was there at all.
What's Webb's form in the job?
Clean sheets since she rejoined. Able and active officer. If she hadn't taken the time out to have kids, she'd be much further up the ladder by now. The only real black mark against her is from years back when she was a young constable.
What's that?
Police accident, smashed the car up while on duty. Reprimanded, suspended from driving for a while.
Thank Governor, it's not good enough, but...
Don't tell me, Harry. Tell Graves. You're to see him immediately on arrival.
What, for timekeeping?
Well, I suppose so. He doesn't confide in me. It's none of my business, mate, but I have tried to warn you.
Yeah, right.
Come. I'm formally notifying you that you are being investigated for carrying on business without the knowledge or permission of your senior officers. You'll be investigated by Superintendent Mortimer from Jupiter Street.
Report to one area tomorrow, where you'll be assigned administrative duties for the duration of the inquiry. Clear your desk of strictly personal items, then leave the building.
For a start, mate, you can forget about this temporary posting. Just be an embarrassment to everyone. What you do is you go sick. You have been seeing a doctor.
No, I haven't.
We'll see one this afternoon, then. Let him know about all the grief you've been getting. He'll understand. What with Joyce's illness and everything.
I'm not trading on that, am I?
You play the card you've got.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
We'll lay on a solicitor for you. I'll fix an appointment with the usual firm if it's all right with you.
Look, Bruce, you're a bloody Federation rep. You know the score as well as any brief, so why don't you tell me where I stand?
I don't really have to tell you, do I, Harry? Your stuff, mate.
What are you trying to say to me?
What I'm saying is walk, don't get pushed. You tell this doctor about all the stress you've been under to get signed off. Lay it on a bit thicker. Go for a medical discharge. Nobody's going to make any waves about that. They'll be only too pleased to see a good officer walk away from the job without embarrassing it.
Speaking of solidarity...
Who was?
I told Harry I'd have a drink with him at the sports and social tonight. I thought it was important that he showed out in public, you know, fronted it up a bit.
Yeah, it's a nice idea, Mo. Give him my best, will you?
What I was wondering was, if you're not doing anything, then a bit of support from his governor wouldn't go amiss.
No can do tonight, I'm afraid. Sorry about that.
Date?
Yeah, kind of.
Do you know what you're going to do?
I don't seem to have many options, do I?
You told Joyce?
I'm working on it. I'm just going to water the elephants.
Choker when a CID officer's under discipline. Oh, I doubt it'll go to a board, Chris. We're talking about old school CID. He'll go on medical grounds like all the other dinosaurs.
Afraid of what else might be found in this locker.
properly rinsed this time, not all smeary.
Homework.
Yeah, I'll be with you in a minute, love.
Oh, I trust that one with the gammy elbow isn't going to start toying himself in half a day this time.
What's going on? You should have told me what you were doing, sweetheart. I'm not a bloody child.
Yeah, well, you know me. I've never been one to bring the job home with me, have I?
Oh, it's such a relief.
What do you mean?
Well, all those nights and weekends. I knew damn well it wasn't the job that was keeping you out.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I should have been straight with you about it.
Yes, you bloody should have. I thought you were going over the side.
Oh, come on, Joyce. What do you think I am, my bleeding governor?
Nah. Well, I suppose I partly expected it.
Why?
Oh, come on, H. Think about it. Those page three bimbos don't have to use walking sticks or even wheelchairs.
You silly bitch. Suppose I ought to take the easy option. Go for a medical discharge.
Is that what you want?
Probably the best.
No. Is that what you want?
I'm thinking of you, ain't I? I mean, if they elbow me and that's my pension down the drain, where are you going to be then?
Oh, Christ, Harry, I'm not a basket case now, and I never will be. I can still fight my corner. You get stuck in and fight yours, all right?
I understand from Mr. Gage that you're seeking a medical opinion, Mr. Naylor, with a view to retirement, which should render any disciplinary proceedings null and void.
No. We could get you another doctor, Harry, if yours is leery about it.
It's not him. It's me. I want this to go to a discipline board. I want a proper finding. I don't want a string of rumours trailing around after me like clinkers out of a dog's arse.
In that case, the only sensible advice I can give you is to cooperate with the investigation and admit the offence.
Like I said, they could sling you out.
Yeah, well, that's the downside. What's the upside? I mean, what's the least they can do to me?
With a plea in mitigation.
That means laying it on the line, Harry. Joyce's illness, your financial situation.
Yeah. With all that and evidence of character from your governors, you might get away with reduction in rank.
And not just one rank, Harry. Most likely they'll bust you down a constable. Christ, you could be directing the bloody traffic.
Well, it's your decision, Harry. That's the way you want to play it.
Well, the thing is, Gov, if I'm going to creep from under this, it's important what my governors are prepared to say about me, innit?
Well, evidence of character. I stand at Graves, isn't it? He's the one who matters.
Yeah, but will he perform?
I don't see why he shouldn't. If it was my character, he might choke on it, but you should be all right.
Well, I'm not so sure about that. I'd feel easier in my mind if someone sounded him out a bit.
Yeah, all right, leave it with me, mate.
Cheers, Gov.
Don't take your coat off, Gov. There's been a development on Webb and Willetts. The property has been recovered, a raid on a fence.
We're talking to
him? I said we'd go round to Wheeler Street this afternoon.
Good.
The report on Webb's Polack makes interesting reading.
Tell me on the way.
She put up her hands for it, so I suppose everybody was satisfied. But the whole story's not there.
That's it? Not much of a lever against Webb.
No, and she had the right people sticking up for her even then. Evidence of character was given in glowing terms by her inspector, one Graham Sullivan.
You're winding me up.
No, our governor. You know that old saying, they can do a lot to you, but they can't do much for you? It's not always true, is it, Gov?
CIB under DS Luke.
Oh, he only just called me, Gov. The fence has come across with the name of the actual burglar. Well known to us, all the right form.
Oh, isn't that convenient?
Sir?
Nice, neat result.
Of course, you're welcome to talk to the fence, but you won't get any more out of him. Now, we just have to give the burglary suspect a pull, but speak to the custody sergeant.
No, I think I'll come along, see what the suspect has to say for himself, while it's fresh. Get whacked, it's their show.
Well, David, what have you got to say to us?
Well, what's the strength of this? I mean, what am I looking at?
If you want all these offences taken into consideration, then you won't be doing any more time than for the burglaries where the property was found in your house.
Yeah? And what about the ruck at the house?
As far as we're concerned, David, you'll have wiped the slate clean.
Yeah, well, all right. I did them.
Good. That's cleared the air, hasn't it? Now, I'd like to put what you've told me into a formal statement for you to sign, and we can talk to the custody sergeant about bail.
Whoa. David, you're admitting to a burglary at 15 Caddick Street, the two porcelain figures?
Yeah.
Well, can you tell us a bit more about that? Quite an unusual experience, wasn't it?
You mean the old lady lying there dead? Yeah, not half. I was out of there like shit off a shovel. But I still had the ornaments away.
How'd you get in?
Broke in.
The police officers who discovered the body found the place to be secure. They broke in.
We're putting 20 burglaries to you, David. Now, I'm sure you remember the property you took. But do you have a clear recollection of how you got into each particular place?
No.
If you found a window open, you'd be in there, wouldn't you?
Oh, yeah. I mean, that's what must have happened.
The police officers didn't find an open window.
Well, I must have shut it behind me, mustn't I?
I think that sews it up nicely. Thanks for your input.
You know what Harry would say?
What?
Looks all squared away to me, Gov.
We're still being head over backwards. Mm.
Speaking of Harry...
Yeah, I know. I'll speak to Grace now.
We're minded to make Maureen acting inspector. Chance for her to prove she can hack it.
Yes, sir. Excellent choice. About Harry.
It's a sorry business, isn't it? Be aware, Tony, there's only so much that can be done.
You are giving evidence of character for Harry.
Oh, yes. I'll give a resume of his record, which has been excellent in parts, and, make it quite clear that he's given no cause for dissatisfaction under my command.
You couldn't see your way to being a little more positive, perhaps?
I think I'm the best judge of what's in order.
With respect, sir, you're not being asked to give a reference for some bloke who swabs the cells out. This is a colleague and a mate who's entitled to his governor's support.
Support isn't the same as going out on a limb. It's going to be difficult enough to climb the greasy pole without being weighed down by misplaced loyalties to subordinates who've embarrassed the service. You might bear that in mind yourself, Tony.
Thank you so much for your time, sir.
If Graves isn't going to do the business for Harry, what about you chipping in?
Maybe, but not sure my £2 would count for much, would it?
It'd be something.
Yeah, but you got to look at these things a bit politically, Mo. I mean, Graves is my governor. I'd be showing him up.
You used to jump at chances like that.
Yeah, well, we all have to grow up sometimes, don't we?
So, basically, you think Graves is right, helping Harry is a bad career move?
I didn't say I wouldn't do it. I just have to box clever, that's all. I want to get on in this job too, you know?
On crisps.
A couple of packets, cheese and onion.
Angela, hello. I didn't realise this was your local.
Hello, Tony. Miles away from home, aren't you? This is my husband, Donald. Tony Clark from work.
Not another spook.
Nothing so exotic.
Join us for a drink?
Yes. Cheers, Donald. I'll have half a lager, please. No crisps.
We'll take these out in the garden, shall we, Donald?
I'll see you there.
What the hell are you doing?
Saving my life and yours.
You wouldn't dare.
Watch me.
The property's recovered. Morgan's put his hands up. Me and Willett's on an offer for anything criminal.
Well, maybe so. But my governor can be a bit of a maniac when he's being had over, and he might just want to make a meal of this. If we were informally aware of the true situation, then I might persuade him to let sleeping dogs lie.
Okay. Me and Willits didn't answer the shout together. We were around the corner talking to a householder. I told Willits to go on ahead and just suss the place out while I finished what I was doing. He got overzealous, broke in, lost his bottle when he saw the corpse and ran straight back to me.
So the place was left wide open?
10, maybe 15 minutes by the time I put Willits back together and returned to the scene. Me and Willits didn't know there'd been a job done until the niece arrived and started squawking.
By which time you were on record with a porky about events at the scene?
Enough said.
Well, nearly, Carol. I'll tell you what would convince me to put it to bed. I'd really like to know what happened all those years ago with that accident of yours when Mr. Sullivan stuck his neck out for you.
There you are, Alex. These are cheese and onion.
Salt and vinegar, all right?
Yeah, cheers.
Reckon you'd do better without your shades on.
What about books? Do you read books? Do you
ever read books?
I don't know when she last read a book.
Why don't, instead of watching Neighbours one night, why don't you just buy yourself a bottle?
All
right. There's your gin and tonic. Cakes, St. Clements and cheese and onion crisps. Is that right?
Thank you.
Find a shandy for Donald.
Cheers. Girl who's driving. Can't tear Alex away from the cretin machine, I suppose.
No, he seems happy enough.
We've got quite intelligent simulators on the PC at home, but he'd rather feed money into a shoot-'em-up game in an arcade.
Well, to be honest, I prefer games where there's a bit of sudden death involved. Winners, losers, clear result.
Life isn't like that, though, Tony.
Well, you can make it that way if you really know what you want.
You learn what you want by imagining someone taking it away. Then you realize what's bedrock and what's just superficial. An optional extra.
The great thing about computer games is that you don't have to sacrifice realism to excitement.
Yeah, well, that's just you against a machine. That's not combat, is it?
Well, it can be. The software lets the players fight each other through the phone lines.
Well, you've got an idea there, Donald. We should take each other on. Mind you, I never play games just for sportsmanship. There'd have to be a prize.
I don't think you should, Tony. Donald would be playing at home with the crowd on his side, 100%. No contest.
You're in Brighton early for a Monday morning, Gov?
Put it down to insomnia. About Harry's evidence of character, Mum.
Yeah?
I'll do it.
That's great. So what changed your mind?
Nothing to lose.
You mean Angela?
Yeah, what they've got, I can't steal that. I can only smash it. But about Harry, my speaking up will just redress the balance a bit. It's not a clincher.
No. The commander would be, though, wouldn't he?
Well, that would be strong, but why should he stick his neck out? Harry's got nothing on Sullivan.
No, but I have. Thing is, though, I can't front him up with it. I'm only an acting inspector. I mean, he'd never wear it from me.
All right, let's hear it. Hope I haven't kept you waiting, sir.
No, no. A bit surprised by the location, though.
Yeah, I wanted to take it out of the office because it's really a personal favour I need to ask you, sir.
Oh, yes.
Everyone at CIB is very keen to do everything they can to help Inspector Naylor.
Yes, I know that.
I was wondering whether that extended to the operational.
I'm sure we all have every sympathy with Naylor and his predicament. But I think that evidence of character should be Mr. Graves' responsibility.
Yes, sir. Normally I would agree with you entirely, but there are issues of the service's organisational culture which you might want to take into consideration.
Really?
Let me give you a hypothetical example, sir. Say there was an officer in the rank of, inspector. And he was involved in a police accident when he had, in fact, taken drink. Shall we sit down? Now, let's say there's a WPC with him who hadn't touched a drop. She stands up for the accident. Gets some grief, nothing permanent, and an officer's career has been saved.
I hope nobody imagines a case like that could be raked up years afterwards.
No, sir, no, not in terms of criminal or disciplinary proceedings. Of course not, perish the thought. But if that officer were to display a narrow view of his loyalty to his subordinates and the story was to achieve a wider currency, well, I don't think the troops could respect a man in that situation, sir, and an officer who isn't respected...
I'd shut it right there, Clark, or I'll report this conversation.
Well, put it this way, Harry, he didn't say no.
And whatever happens, the governor's going to stick up for
me. Oh, that's terrific. I really appreciate what you've done. No, you really stuck your necks out for me. I don't want to say, really.
Don't give it another thought, Harry. It's the least we could do.
You don't know the whole story, Gov.
You can tell us.
One night I was on duty at the security firm and one of the alarm systems was taken offline, unofficial. Not put down in the log. Later on, I took a monkey and used notes, which was written down as wages.
Oh, terrific.
I've just put the black on the commander to swear you're Mary Poppins, and you tell me you could be on offer for corruption and conspiracy?
Yeah, well, I didn't know I was going to drop anybody in it, did I? Look, I'll stand up for it all at the board tomorrow. How about that?
Just whose alarm got knocked off?
It's a solicitor. McNichol and Flower.
And they were done that night?
Well, I don't know. I didn't want my prints all over a PNC check, did I?
All right, well, before you do your Captain Oates and walk out into the snowstorm, perhaps we'd better find out informally.
And if you don't mind, you'd really be helping me out. I'm doing a part-time MBA. Because the police are very managerially minded these days, and we have to do a spot of consumer research.
Yeah, all right.
Oh, great. So this is McNichol and Flower.
Yep.
Solicitors. Now, as a firm, what's been your experience of the way police have handled your complaints about crime in the last 6 months?
What crime?
Any crime at all.
Oh, there hasn't been any. I mean, I had my handbag stolen from out here when I went to the loo. But that was a year ago now, when we still did legal aid.
Okay, Mo, what's the damage?
There's no damage.
Eh?
The premises weren't burgled the night the alarm went down, so if Harry was suspicious about what he saw, his suspicions were misplaced.
Oh, bollocks. Why else would they knock the alarm off? What are they banging my monkey for?
Well, I don't know that, but it doesn't look like Harry's problem, so you can do the business at the board.
No, I still want to know the strength of this before I swear it away. Okay, Mo, you get back to the office. Tell Harry I'll be along.
He needs you, Garth.
Yes, yes, I'll be there.
Okay,
hello. Give us a bell when you know something.
Yeah. See about lunchtime.
Well, I'm not
with one of our vans, Mr. Graves. I'm sure the driver would have reported it.
Well, you can see the damage for yourself. Burglar alarm's getting switched off. What's the screw?
Look, I'm a police officer, I'm in a hurry, and if I have to listen to any old bollocks, I'll have the old bill crawling all over this place with tweezers for a month.
I wouldn't find a thing.
Yeah, perhaps not. But your customers would vote with their feet and the shareholders with them. So talk to me about burglar alarms.
Everything's totally legitimate. It's all been sanctioned. You don't have to believe me, mate. We've got a consultant deals with all this.
Oh, yeah? And what's his name?
John Deakin.
Now, this is the hearing of the case against Detective Inspector Henry Naylor. By a discipline board held on the 24th of September, 1993. Are you legally represented in this case?
Yes, sir, by Mr. Donner.
You're charged with carrying on business without the permission or knowledge of your superior officers. Do you admit or deny the offence with which you're charged?
I admit the offence.
Well, the facts of the case will be given by the presenting officer.
Deakin?
Have you got an appointment?
No.
Then I'll have to ask you to wait.
Your manners haven't improved.
Implicating Harry Naylor in some bit of work of yours and then grassing on him. That'd be your idea of getting even, wouldn't it, for us doing your legs?
Piss off, Clark. I'm a busy man. It's payment by results in the private sector.
Can you answer the question? Harry got involved in something dodgy at the security firm. What was it?
I'm not Naylor's minder.
Deakin, if you swallowed a nail, you'd shit a corkscrew. Whatever was going on down there, you knew about it.
I'm under no obligation to discuss the firm's business with you. If you suspect an offense, get on with proving it. But either shit or get off the pot, Clark. Now, any more of this harassment, and I'm putting in a complaint.
I'm having you, Deakin.
In your dreams. I will tell you this much, though. I didn't grass Naylor up. Christ, the man was in company uniform. Any slag with a grievance could have spotted him. But you can tell poor old Harry he's fireproof in terms of what he did at the company. As indeed am I. And Tony, rest assured, if ever I find the time to settle old scores, I'll be wanting the engine driver, not the oily rag.
Those are the facts in this case, which are not disputed by the accused officer.
That is correct. Do you or your legal representative wish to address the discipline board at this stage?
No, Mr. Chairman.
Well, the board finds that the case is proved. Do you or your legal representative wish to address the discipline board in mitigation of punishment?
Sir, we have character witnesses who will give evidence of Mr. Naylor's excellent record in the police service. However, before calling them, some mitigating observations are in order.
During his period under my command, Mr. Naylor has carried out his duties conscientiously and effectively to the best of my knowledge, and given me no cause for complaint.
Thank you, Mr. Graves. Detective Superintendent Clark is our next character witness. You are Detective Superintendent Anthony Clark, the accused officer's direct superior in the Complaints Investigation Bureau.
That's correct. I've worked with Inspector Naylor since I was first posted to CIB. Without a loyal, diligent, and scrupulously honest bagman, my job as investigating officer would have been impossible. But my debt to him goes further than that. There were times when Inspector Naylor's loyalties were stretched beyond most people's breaking point. Duty and the interests of justice obliged him to do things he'd rather not have done. He didn't flinch from that duty. It's on my conscience that in recent months I failed to recognize the pressure that Harry was under. Perhaps if I'd been more vigilant, this present state of affairs might have been avoided. The past can't be undone. But I trust that any officer who, like me, has been tempted to bend the rules in pursuit of a good cause will want to blend the maximum possible mercy with any justice meted out to Inspector Naylor.
Thank you, Mr. Clark. Our final character witness is Commander Graham Sullivan. You are Commander Graham Sullivan of the Complaints Investigation Bureau.
I am. I was eager to offer evidence of character in the case of Inspector Naylor because all too often the troops at the sharp end feel that the higher echelons leave them to face the music unsupported.
Desk jockey out in the field, Miss B. Your whistleblowing civil servant must have caused a flutter under Dovecot.
What have you got?
The material isn't deposited with his solicitors. Shall we look further?
We'll let you know. No comebacks, I trust.
Nickel and Flower aren't even aware they've been searched.
Anyway, our man is completely deniable.
So are you.
The board awards the following punishment. Reduction to the rank of sergeant and a fine, equivalent to 3 months' pay.
Thank you, sir.
The board recommends your transfer from CIB.
That was a remarkable exercise in damage limitation, Anthony. Wonder if anybody will do the same for you when it's your turn.
Oh, that'll be the day, sir.